Some Japanese wood joints seem almost impossible at first glance. One example is the double dovetail tenon. We'll show you here how the joint works. The joint is marked out using a Japanese carpenter square and a sharp pencil. The timbers have a cross section of 45 by 45 millimeters. The tenon goes straight through. Mark the length of 45 millimeters all round. The top dovetail must be marked on both sides. On the inside, 10 millimeters less than the width of the wood, and on the outside, 5 millimeters less. The tenon narrows along the whole length from 30 millimeters on the inside to 15 millimeters on the outside at the front end. For marking, the 15 millimeter side width of the Sashigane is very practical. To mark out the dovetail on the front end, clamp the workpiece upright. Mark the basic 45 millimeters width of the mortise on the top side and continue it on the sides. The depth of the mortise measured from above is 30 millimeters on the inside and on the outside at the front end 15 millimeters. To mark the top dovetail, again offset it at the front end by 5 millimeters and on the inside by 10 millimeters on each side. From this inward offset, the dovetail runs in each case to the base of the mortise outwards along the whole width. To cut the dovetail tenon, use a ryoba. This Japanese saw has different teeth on each side of the blade. The side with the coarser rib teeth is ideal for cutting along the grain. The first cut is a slightly angled rib cut. Then turn the workpiece by 90 degrees. The first saw cut acts as a guide for the second and third cuts on the averted side of the workpiece. The saw runs almost by itself in the pre-made slit. To remove the pieces you don't want, use a dozuki, a Japanese saw with a reinforced back and thinner blade. Only now does the first part fall out of the joint. Make sure the cuts all run exactly at the base of the tenon. To make the mortise, clamp the workpiece to the workbench. Use the dozuki to cut the sides of the mortise. To make sure you don't saw beyond the base of the mortise, turn the workpiece several times. With the last few saw cuts, make sure the cuts end exactly in the corners of the slanted slits and you don't saw beyond there. An additional saw cut, roughly the width of a chisel, makes it easier to chisel out the mortise next. To chisel out the mortise, turn the workpiece on its side and mark the base with a white chisel by lightly tapping. Then use a narrower chisel to first roughly remove the material from the joint. Also, on the outside, first mark the base of the mortise with a wide chisel. Once you have roughly removed most of the wood, you can smooth the base and clean out the corners of the joint. Only guide the chisel by hand to do this, don't tap it. The chisel will need to be well sharpened. Now cut the workpiece to size and assemble the joint. It fits. Use a Japanese plane to smooth down the joint. All done. At Dictum, you'll find original Japanese tools for making traditional wood joints, as well as a variety of craft and woodworking courses.